Now let's see about hierarchical pacing, or this can also be known as hierarchical pace table, or multi-level pacing, or two-level pacing, three-level pacing, like that. First, let's see where we can use this hierarchical pacing. If we want to store lakhs of entries in a pace table, then we use this hierarchical pacing. Let's see an example. Let us assume that the size of a logical address, the size of logical address is 32 bits. Size of logical address is 32 bits. Whereas the size of a page, the size of a page is 4 kilobyte. We can write 4 as 2 power 2. 1 kilobyte is equal to 1024 bits. 1024 is nothing but 2 power 10. So this is nothing but 2 power 1. So here the size of a page is 2 power 1. That means a page may contains 2 power 12 locations. So here, what is the logical address size here? 32 bits. Here the logical address is divided into two parts. The first part specifies page number, whereas the second part specifies offset or displacement. Offset means a particular location in the page. Here, how many locations are possible in a page? 2 power 12. That means here D means 12. What is the size of the logical address here? 32 bits. So the page number will become 32 minus 1, that is nothing but 20. So the size of a page number is 20 bits, whereas the size of the offset is 12 bits. So 20 plus 12 means 32 bits. So here the size of a page number is 20 bits. So totally we can store 2 power 20 page numbers in a page table. So 2 power 20 means 10 lakhs, more than 10 lakhs. So that means we have to store 10 lakhs entries in a page table. So if we store 10 lakh entries in a page table, then what will happen here is we need to store the entire page table in a main memory. So that for accessing the main memory, we need to require much amount of time. So in order to overcome that problem here, what we are doing is, instead of storing the entire page table information in one page table, we are splitting that information among multiple page tables. So one page table contains some limited of information. The remaining information is available in another page table. So likewise, we can split the information among multiple page tables so that the burden on a single page table will be reduces. Let's take an example here so that we will get the complete clarity. So initially, CPU generated a logical address. So in order to execute an instruction, initially CPU generated logical address. Let the size of a logical address is 32 bits, where D means 12 bits. So here D is nothing but 12 bits. So what is the page number here? 20 bits. Here we can divide that page number into two parts, P1 and P2, where P1 size is 10 bits, P2 size is 10 bits. So 10 plus 10 means 20. So 20 is nothing but the size of the page number. So this P1 will be given as an index, an input to the outermost page table. If we have two for loops, then the first for loop is known as outermost for loop, then the next for loop is known as innermost for loop. So likewise here, this page table is known as outermost page table. So this page table accepts this page number as the input, and it produces an offset. So that offset will be given as an index to the next page table. So this is known as inner page table, or a page of this page table, a page of this outermost page table. So this offset will be given as an index to this page table. So this page table will produce frame number as the output. If we combine the frame number with this offset, it will give the exact physical address in the main memory. This is known as two-level pacing. This is known as two-level pacing. Why? Because in this example, what we are doing, we are splitting the page number into two parts, as well as we have how many page tables? We have two page tables. So that's why we can call this as some two-level pacing. Suppose if you want to maintain some three-level pacing, let us assume that CPU generated a logical address of 64 bits. So in that, let the size of your page is 4 kilobyte. So how much space will be occupied by the offset? D, the size of D is what? 12 bits. So 64 minus 12 means what? 52. So the remaining bits are occupied by some page numbers. So we can split this 52 into three parts, P1, P2 and P3, where P1 stores some 32 bits of information, P2 stores some 10 bits, P3 stores some 10 bits. So 32, 10, 42. So 32 means 32 plus 10 means 42. 42 plus 10 means 52. So here, how many page tables we have to maintain? If there are three page numbers, then we need to maintain three page tables. Okay, this P1 will be given as input to the outermost page table. It will give an offset. That offset will be given to the second page table. It will give one more offset. That offset will be given to the inner last table. That is nothing but innermost page table. That page table will give the frame number. So if we combine frame number with the offset, it will give the exact physical address in the main memory. So this is about hierarchical paging or hierarchical page table or multi-level paging or two-level paging or three-level paging.